guys, so today we're going to be doing a few new activities. We're going to start off with some juggling. After we've done that, we're going to move on to some new tongue twisters. Then we'll have a trick, and finally, of course, our fun fact of the day. So let's get on with it. So now we're going to do a little bit of juggling. So for this activity, you'll need three round objects. It doesn't have to be a ball, it just needs to be something that resembles a ball. And I've got these three lemons. Okay, Bonnie, they're not for you. So what we're going to do first is we're going to put two of these lemons to the side and we're just going to work with one. So what we need to do is we need to put it in one hand and we're just going to pass it from one side to the other, like so. Wally, it's not for you. Okay, so once you've done that and you've practiced that for a little while, the next thing you're going to do is you're going, not for you, Bonnie. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to put your lemon in one hand and you're going to throw it up in one hand and to throw it into the other. And then once it's in this hand, up it goes into the other. Up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. And just keep practicing it over and over. So now you've learned two different things. One is just passing it from hand to hand. Thank you, Bonnie. And the other is up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Good. All right, once you've mastered that, let's bring the other ball in. So now we have two, and we're going to bring the two techniques together. We're going to throw one of these lemons up, and the other one we're going to pass across to the other hand. Okay, so this is how it's done. This one goes up, and this one goes across. Let's see if I can do it. All right, up, across. There we are, I did it. And again, up, across, up, across, up, across. Make sure you throw it relatively high so that you have time to pass across. And again, whoopsie, Bonnie. And up, across, up, across, up, across, up, across. Just keep practicing. Okay, now the final stage is this. You need to bring the third lemon in, okay? I hope I can do this. Okay, so you're going to, one of the lemons is gonna go up, the other one is gonna pass across, and in the time that it's being passed across, the other one's being thrown up, so it's going round, up, up, all the way around, like in a circle. Okay, let's see if I can do it. I'm not the greatest at this, okay? Up, up, up. Not so good. Let's try again. Up, up, up. Yay, I did it. Let's try again. Up, up, up. Oh no, that wasn't so good. Bunny, where's it gone? Okay, and again. Last time. Up, up, up. Yay. You get practicing it and see if you can do it too. I hope you've been practicing the tongue twisters from last time. Do you remember? Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper. Do you remember? I know that Matty G did it fantastically well, but today we're going to be doing a new one. Now this one's about swans. So let's see if we can get practicing. This is how it goes. Swans swim over the sea. Swim, swan, swim. Swans swam over the sea. Swim, swan, swim. Oh dear, I got a little bit wrong. You see, it's not easy even when you're doing it slowly. Let's see if I can do it a little bit quicker. Swans swam over the sea. Swim, swan, swim. Swans swam over the sea. Swim, swan, swam. Oh dear, I'm not so good at it, but you can do it better than me. Okay, there's one more that I want you to do, but this one's very tricky. And, well, sometimes it comes out a little bit wrong and you'll know what I mean when I say it. So this is how it goes. I am not a pheasant's plucker. I'm a pheasant's plucker's son. Not easy. Let me say it again slowly. I am not a pheasant plucker. I'm a pheasant's plus. Oh dear. Let's say it again. I am not a pheasant's plucker. I'm a pheasant's plucker's. Pheasant's plucker's son. Okay, I can't even do it slowly. Let's see if I can do it a bit quicker. I am not a pheasant's plucker. I'm a pheasant's plucker's son. Oh, it's a little bit easier when you do it quick. Try on your own. And let's do it together. One last time. I am not a pheasant's plucker. I'm a pheasant's plucker's son. Have a go and see how you get on. Let me see. Send it to me and let me see how you get on too. For the trick of the day. Now for this trick, again, all that you'll need is a piece of paper and a marker. But before we do the trick, I want to talk to you a little bit about an artist called Pablo Picasso, and he came from a country called Spain. Now, he was born in Spain, but actually he lived most of his life in France. And he was a fantastic artist who did very minimalistic work, which means that he was able to draw things very simply and you were able to see and appreciate them very well. He is very famous for drawing his animals, and his animals were done primarily with just one line. So just let's have a little look and see. So what I want you to do is to try and do this yourself. Be a little Picasso yourself, okay? What I want you to do is to draw three circles and then to try and create three different animals on your own. I'm sure you can do it. Have a go and let me know how you get on. Okay, so let's get drawing. Let's see if we can draw some animals, but very minimalistically, okay? Now, I'm no Picasso, believe me, but I think I can draw animals relatively well. But let's start all our animals just with a regular circle. So what I'm going to do here is just draw three circles of around the same size. So let's start with this one. And I think what I'm going to do is with this one, I'm going to draw a rabbit. So let's start with two lovely eyes in the center, and then I'll draw just a little nose, and there we have the mouth, and then we have long ears, and I'll just draw inside, so you'll see that these are like the inside of the bunny's ears. Okay, and then I'll just draw a little inside. I think you can see that that is a rabbit. I've hardly drawn anything, but it's very clear that this is a rabbit. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. The next one is going to be a different animal. Let's see if you can guess what it is. I'll start with the ears. There's one, and there's the other. Again, let me do the inside of the ears. There we are. Now I will do the two little eyes inside, like that. Now I have the nose, and then I have the mouth. And you will see here, I have a little bit inside the forehead, and then I have the stripes on the side here, on either side. And then you'll see, I'm just going to put a few whiskers on either side. Now again, I've hardly drawn any lines, but again, I think it's pretty clear that this is a ferocious tiger. Okay, so now let's move on to the third and final animal. Now this animal is actually one of my favorite animals, and it's very easy to do. So first we're going to draw this line in the middle, this shape, And then we're going to just draw lines all the way round. Can you guess what it is yet? Let's have a look, let's continue. Now we have the head, like so, okay? And two little eyes. Then we have one foot, and the other foot, and the other foot, and the other foot. And what are we missing? Just a lovely little tail. Could we guess what it is yet? Yes, it's a beautiful turtle. Okay, what I'd like you to do is for you all to try and do this at home. Just draw a circle and then see if you can make an animal of your own. Then send them to me. I'd love to see them and I can maybe put them on my film. All right. The fun fact of the day. Now today's fact is about beluga whales. Now I don't know if you've ever seen a beluga whale, but they're the most beautiful animal. They're white. Now the word beluga actually comes from the Russian word meaning white. And they're very friendly animals. Did you know that they can dive for 25 minutes under the water without needing to come up and take a breath? Now, penguins and beluga whales live in totally different places and generally they would never ever meet. But in this clip you will see in a zoo that the penguins took a little walk to the area where the beluga whales live and they got very friendly together. Have a look and see. Today, I hope you enjoyed all the activities. Please get practicing that juggling and let's see if you can do those animals for me too. Now, something else I wanted to talk to you about just very quickly is the talent show. A lot of you have sent me clips of you doing wonderful things, but those of you who haven't, please send me something. I think it will be wonderful if everybody can participate and then I can make a lovely film of everybody doing special things. So, get creating and send it to me as soon as you can. Until next time, bye for now.